Believe me, I'm so happy you folks are here tonight. You seem like a wonderful audience, and God, last night's crowd, oh, they were horrible. And I hate talking about people when they're not here, but fist fights, honest to God, fist fights broke out. They were upset when they realized Oprah wasn't giving away cars. So upset. Oh, is that ugly. Last night down in Washington, D.C., President Bush lighted the National Christmas Tree. It's a 40-foot spruce. It was chopped down and trucked to the White House by Dick Cheney's lesbian daughter. True story. You know, we're going to go into the audience tonight to play America's fastest growing quiz sensation, Know Your Current Events. But, no, wait a minute, I'm nervous now because earlier a guy from Seattle wouldn't know how tall I was. And I'm thinking I go out there, he may cold cock me. But here we go, it's time to play America's fastest growing quiz sensation, Know Your Current Events. Let's play.
Yeah,
nice to see you. What's your name, sir?
Kevin.
Kevin, you're from Seattle, right?
That's right.
Yeah. How tall are you?
6'5".
6'5". Wow, that's pretty good. What do you do in Seattle?
I'm a student.
Student, where do you go to school?
Western Washington University.
What are you studying there?
Political science.
And when you get out, you're going to do what?
Go back to school.
Uh-huh. How do you like New York City? It's fun, isn't it?
It's nice. Yeah, yeah. It's warm.
Yeah. But Seattle's beautiful, though, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. How about those Seahawks? What do you think?
Pretty good team, huh?
Yeah. Yeah. You know, they beat the Giants on Sunday.
I noticed.
That was ugly, wasn't it?
Yeah. We'll take it, though.
Really?
Yeah.
You were happy with the way that came? A guy blows three easy field goals, and you guys win?
It was given to us. We'll take it.
All right. We're playing Know Your Current Events. Are you excited about this?
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to ask you some questions. You look at the thing right there, and we go. Here we go. Ready? What did Oprah do yesterday? There's Oprah right there. What did Oprah do yesterday? Think about that. What did Oprah do yesterday? She was on the show yesterday, right here on our show. What did Oprah do yesterday?
She answered your questions.
No. She began a new 20-year streak of hating my guts. Lovely woman. Do you like being 6'5"?
Yeah, I enjoy it.
I'd like to be 6'5", too. You don't want to hurt me or anything, do you?
No.
Yeah. Here we go again. How do we know it was Nick, not Jessica, who filed for divorce? Oh, this is sad. There's Jessica Simpson and Nick Lachey. How do we know that it was Nick who filed and not Jessica? How do we know? Citing irreconcilable differences. How do we know that it was Nick, not Jessica? It's a tough one, isn't it?
It is tough.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Well, you're like the rest of us. You're having trouble dealing with your grief. Because she doesn't know what irreconcilable difference means. All right, come on. Hey, Vicky, look. Look at the size of this guy. Dinner for two, Rosa Mexicana. There's some music from the show. And then there's your Explodo Pop, the common card exploding popcorn. Nice meeting you. Thank you very much for being here. Guys from Seattle. My friend Vicky. Hi, Vicky. How's it going? Nice to see you.
Good, Mr. Carney. Mm-hmm. How was your Thanksgiving?
Well, I had a great Thanksgiving. You know what I did? I drove up to Maine to visit my elderly aunt. It was a lovely time.
Banger?
Of course not. It's my elderly aunt. Wrong with you? Is something wrong with you? Did you say that just to irritate me? Why would you say a thing like that? Banger, of course not. She's almost 90, for God's sake. You should be ashamed of yourself. Would you like to play? What's your name, sir?
Chris.
Where are you from, Chris?
Billerica, Massachusetts.
Oh, I don't know anything about that. Where is that?
It's a couple minutes south of Lowell.
Mm-hmm. Don't know anything about Lowell either. Are you on the coast? Is that on the coast?
20 minutes north of Boston.
20 minutes north of Boston. Well, you guys have had quite a year, except for the collapse of the Patriots.
No, we still have faith.
They won't make the playoffs, will they?
No, we're first place in the East.
Well, that doesn't mean anything, does it really? I'm first placed in the East. What do you do for a living?
I'm a high school teacher.
Oh, what grade do you teach?
Pretty much juniors and seniors.
Mm-hmm. And what classes?
American history.
American history.
Yeah.
Oh, that's great. And do kids love American history? Of course, you're right there, kind of in the cradle of American history in New England. Do they must love it, right?
They don't care much about that.
Don't care much about it. And what kind of things do you teach them about? What's your favorite part of American history?
Probably like the American Revolution,
mm-hmm.
Civil War.
Mm-hmm. Do you ever cover the time when I left NBC to come to CBS? Is that... Talk about history. So your name was Kevin?
Chris,
all right. Are you ready to play?
Sure.
This is Know Your Current Events. I'm going to show you a thing on the screen. You answer the question.
Okay.
This is the time of year New Yorkers are excitedly counting down the days until what? We're excitedly counting down the days until what? This time of year. Think about it, Chris.
I have to go with Christmas.
Oh, no. It's the end of the Jets season. End of the Jets season. You like chowder?
Love it.
So you have the New England chowder, and is that white or red?
It's white.
And Manhattan is red,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Oh, man. And you get clam chowder?
Oh, yeah.
It's the best, isn't it?
Yeah,
okay. Here we go. Elton John announced that on December 21st, there he is right there, he plans to marry whom? Elton John is marrying whom? Quite an announcement. December 21st, he'll be marrying whom?
His boyfriend.
That's what you'd think, but no, the surprise answer is Katie Holmes. Hey, Vicky, how are you? A banger thing. Well, of course not. That's my elderly aunt. Oh, this is nice. Dinner for two at 21. Music from the show. And there's your exploding popcorn.
Thank you very much.
Thank Happy you. Holidays. Good to meet you. Thank you very much. Thank you, Vicky. Would you like to play? Let's play. What's your name, ma'am?
Gwen,
where are you from?
Mississippi.
What town in Mississippi?
Clarksdale.
I don't know where that is either.
It's about 60 miles below Memphis.
60 miles below Memphis. So in that part of the state, you probably did not suffer the ravages of any of the hurricanes? Well, good for you. You're blessed in that regard, certainly. And what do you do down there in Mississippi?
Well, I have a little gift shop.
Mm-hmm. And what kind of things do you sell?
We sell accessories, home accessories.
Accessories? And like, what's an accessory? What's a popular...
Lamps,
right?
Gifts, mm-hmm. items.
Now, where do you get your stuff? Is it new or is it antique items?
No, it's new.
All new. Now, tell me, if you can, without divulging any trade secrets, when you buy, like, a lamp or something from a supplier, what a markup are we talking about? When I go into your store and I see a lamp, it might be, like, $100 for a lamp?
True.
Okay, what are you paying for that lamp?
About 50.
Oh, so it's like double?
100%.
So you are really doing quite well, aren't you? Really, even doubling the price, you're not doing well? That's not enough to cover the overhead and stuff like that?
Well, we live in a little bit different area than New York
mm-hmm.
City. So.
Yeah, and what's the most popular item there?
Well, let's see, probably bridal gifts, china, crystal.
Right. You know what would be a nice item is a set of dishware with my face on the plates. Would you be interested? And then maybe some with Paul and the band, and the dessert and the plates or something.
Yeah. Is that price for them? Very good dessert. Ah, thank you.
Well, what are you doing in New York? Having fun?
We're having a great time.
You come here a lot?
No, this is my first time.
First time. Good for you. I'm glad you're here. And you came at a nice time of year, the holiday season. All right, let's play here. Know Your Current Events. George Bush there. We're going to take a look at the thing. George Bush is sad to see his rating still stuck at 39. What rating are we talking about? He's sad to see that his rating is still stuck at 39. What rating, Gwen, are we talking about right there? What green?
Popularity.
Oh, no. His IQ. IQ is still stuck at 39. Okay, you want to go one more time?
One more.
Okay, now this one's tough. I've glanced ahead and I can tell you that this one's not easy. What's the number one tip the post office is telling the public this holiday season? The number one tip, you know, they're always saying, here's what you do, this is what you need to do, it's crowded, it's our biggest mailing time of year. What is the number one tip the post office is telling the public this holiday season? Think about
mail
it.
Mail early.
Oh, see? No, that's not right. For faster service, pre-break your items before mailing. Pre-break. Hey, Vicky, she's from Mississippi. Get her for two at Mittagur. I think that'll be lovely. There's some music. There's your Explode Pop popcorn. Pleasure meeting you. Happy Christmas. Nice to see you. There you go, Vicky. Those are yours. Thank you very much. Yeah, I know. Now, we met Know Your Current Events, we met a lovely woman from Mississippi who has a gift shop, and I was thinking, well, maybe this would be perfect. What this is this is a Christmas tree, like a lead glass, stained glass Christmas tree.
Look at that. That's beautiful.
Of me.
Yes. Leaded glass. Wait a minute. What's that price?
$2,500.
So I know what that would mean.
Huh?
Is that wholesale or retail?
Well, this is, she'll get this when she sells
that's
it.
That's retail herself. Price,
this
yes.
This is retail, that's right.
Yes, I see.
Good luck. I'm sure that'll be a very popular item. Thank you very much. $2,500 right there. There's no overhead.
She's getting it for free.
She'll get to keep all of that.
2,500. Percent markup on
it's gonna
that.
Be crazy yeah. down there. Yeah, it'll be lines
over
around
zero.
The block when she puts
Man.
That in the window. Last night, something wonderful happened. Oprah Winfrey was on the program, and what did you think of that?
Just last night. Well, it was a veritable. What do we used to call it? A carousel of love? What was it?
It's the Super Bowl of love.
It was the Super Bowl,
Super Bowl
of love. It really was.
Yeah. But you know, now the network, CBS, is all over it. Have you seen what they're doing?
What do you mean?
This is what the network is running today. She hadn't been on the show in 16 years. Now take a look at what the CBS network is
going
to watch.
On?
America is talking about last night's Late Show with very special guest, Oprah Winfrey. And don't miss Oprah's next Late Show appearance in 2021. Then catch Craig.
That's right. Ladies and gentlemen, here's tonight's top 10 list. Let's go. Top 10 signs you've hired a bad department store Santa. We're right in the thick of this season where everywhere you go, there's a Santa Claus. Most of them are great.
Of course.
Every now and then, just by the sheer numbers of it, you're going to get somebody who's not so good. Here, top 10 signs you've hired a bad department store Santa. And to present tonight's top 10 list, your Bloomingdale's department store Santa. Santa, come on in. Thank you for being here, Santa. I know this is your busy time of the year. Top 10 signs you've hired a bad department store Santa. Take it away, number 10.
Fluffy white beard is heavily soiled with chaw stains.
Number 9.
Lectures each child on the wonders of Scientology.
Bad Santa. Oh, yeah. Bad Santa. Number 8.
There's always two or three L's on defibrillator duty.
Now, that's not a bad idea. Number 7.
Tries to snort the fake snow.
Number 6.
The suit is more orange than red and reads Auburn Correctional Facility.
Hey, wait a minute. Whoa. Number 5.
Every night he walks out with a sack full of iPods.
Number 4.
Instead of saying ho, 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 keeps mumbling something about jihad.
Number 3.
Tells every kid climbing on his lap, careful of Santa's flask.
Number 2.
Because of earlier incident, can't go within 50 feet of Victoria's Secret sales girls.
Oh, Santa. And the number one sign you've hired a bad department store Santa.
Points out which kids he thinks will be gay.
Hey,